Let's go over the answers to the assessment you just completed. So here was the first problem. Based on your knowledge of vertical asymptotes and limits, which equation matches this graph? Okay, so let's zoom in on the graph for a second and look at some of its main features. Okay, so what stands out to us as important about this graph? Well, the first thing that's pretty important is that the graph has a vertical asymptote at x equals 2. And then, also, on either side of that asymptote, the graph's going to positive infinity. So going to positive infinity on both sides of the asymptote is pretty important. So let's see if we can knock out any choices based on those two pieces of information. And then we'll dig in a little deeper if we have to. Okay, so first of all, we know there's an asymptote at x equals 2. That means that when I plug in x equals 2 to the correct equation, I should be getting 0 in the denominator. So that automatically knocks out one choice for us, choice number 4. Because if I plug in 2 to 4, number 4, I don't get 0 in the denominator. Okay, so we've knocked out one choice. Now, let's use the fact that the graph goes to positive infinity on both sides of the asymptote to knock out another choice. Okay, so the fact that it goes to positive infinity on both sides of the asymptote tells me that if I plug in values that are a little bit greater than 2 and a little bit less than 2, my function should be positive for both of those scenarios. So look at choice number 3. If I plug in values that are slightly greater than 2, I get a positive in that case. But what if I plug in values that are slightly less than 2, like 1.9? If I plugged in 1.9 here, I would get a negative value overall. But we see that's not what happens with the function. We have positive values as we approach the asymptote. So I know it can't be number 3 because of that reason. Okay, so now we're left with two options, and these two options are pretty similar. And actually distinguishing between them is pretty subtle. So what do we have? Both of these options, number 1 and number 2, have x minus 2 quantity squared in the denominator. But option number 1 has x in the numerator, while option number 2 has 1 in the numerator. Okay, so let me show you this graph one more time. Okay, I'm going to point out a fact here that's going to be key to distinguishing between them. So notice here on the left-hand side of the graph that our function dips into negative y values. Okay, so we have some negative y values on this graph. But look at choice number 2. Choice number 2 is 1 over x minus 2 quantity squared. So in choice number 2, the numerator is always positive because it's 1, and the denominator is also always positive because it's squared. So choice number 2 could never be negative. So because of that reason, I know that it's not the choice I'm looking for. The correct choice is choice number 1. It has an asymptote at x equals 2, which we want. On either side of x equals 2, it's positive, which we want. But it does allow for negative values, which we see that our graph has. So that's why choice number 1 is correct in this case. Okay, so let's continue and look at the other problems. Okay, so this is the second assessment you completed, and same directions, just a different graph. So let me zoom in on this graph for us. Okay, so what do we see here? Well, the main thing that stands out to me is that in this case, we have two vertical asymptotes. We have one at x equals negative 2 and one at x equals positive 2. Okay, so that's a pretty unique thing. So let's see if that fact in itself will help us pick the right answer. Okay, so I need to pick an answer that allows for two vertical asymptotes. So whether I plug in 2 or negative 2 to the denominator, I should get 0. So that automatically knocks out a lot of choices. Choice number one only has one vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2. Choice number two also only has one vertical asymptote at x equals positive 2. And same thing for choice number four. Choice four only has one vertical asymptote at x equals 4. Okay, so that was pretty nice, right? I was eliminating three choices right off the bat. So it looks like choice three is the correct answer. Let's just make sure. So out to the side here, I'm just going to show you that if I factor that denominator into x plus 2 and x minus 2, so that's a difference of squares, and I'm just factoring it, then I can clearly see that there are two vertical asymptotes. There are two x values that make this denominator 0. And they're the 2 and the negative 2 that I was looking for. So 3 is the correct answer for this function. All right, one more. Okay. So this one's different, right? This function is unique out of all the ones we've looked at so far. And then it doesn't have any vertical asymptotes. So let me zoom in on it for a second. Okay, so this is what it looks like up close. No vertical asymptotes, just a friendly continuous function. So out of these answer choices, we need to pick a choice that would not have a vertical asymptote. So let's see if we can eliminate any based on that fact. Well, I can eliminate choice number one because it would have a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2. Okay? Okay, number two, I'm not so sure about that one. Let's skip over that one. Number three, well, this is the one I just looked at the previous problem. We know that this function, 1 over x squared minus 4, has vertical asymptotes at x equals negative 2 and x equals positive 2. So it's not what I'm looking for. And number four, I know that that would have a vertical asymptote at x equals 4. Okay, so it looks like number two is the winner in this case. And that's because there's no x value that I can plug into the denominator to make the denominator equal 0, which means there are no vertical asymptotes, and that's exactly what I was looking for in this case.